This is a video on using the second order linear differential equations app. So let's suppose that we want to solve the differential equation y double prime plus 2y prime minus 3y equals sine of x. And we want to use this app. So to do that, I'm just going to type in the coefficients, 1 for y double prime, 2 because I want 2y prime, minus 3y, so negative 3 for minus 3y, and then I want it to be equal to sine of x. So over here you'll see c sine of kx. So if it's just sine of x, c is 1, and k is also 1. That way it's 1 sine of 1x. And let's suppose that I want y of 0 is negative 1, so I go f of 0 equals negative 1, and y prime of 0 equals 1. So y prime of 0, it says 1, and I'll just keep it as a 1. And then I just click on draw. And there's my solution to the differential equation. Now this gives us a lot of different things. It gives us, one thing is it gives us the solution graphically. So here is the curve. It also gives us the solution to the differential equation analytically. Here's the equation, y equals negative about 0.44, e to the negative 3x. Minus 0.33x minus 1. It rounds to two decimal places. And it also gives us a slope field for the differential equations as though we didn't have an f of 0 as negative 1. If I click anywhere, I can get the solution to the differential equation through the point at which I clicked on. So I can play around and you can kind of see all kinds of solutions. If you want a different differential equation, it's very easy. You can just click on whichever the forcing function is. So for example, I might want a polynomial, a quadratic. And I hit draw. And there it is. I can click on a point and see it go through that point also. I could also zoom in. So if I hit Z in, and then I can click maybe in this point that I'm interested in, and it'll zoom in at that point. If I click Z in again, it'll zoom in again. If I click ZSTD, that goes back to where I was before, and I can hit draw, and there's our solution in the standard negative 10 to 10 for x and y. Notice that if I move my mouse around, it shows the coordinates at which the mouse points at. I can also set my window with x min, x max, y min, and y max. So if I want, say, negative 1 to 1, for x, and negative 1 to 1 for y. There it is. That may not be too interesting because it's way below, so maybe I'll go y min, how about negative 6. And there's our solution with our new window here. If you want a homogeneous differential equation, then we want to go to the cx plus k, and if we set k equals 0, and c also equals 0, for example, then we'll get a homogeneous solution. Let's go z standard to get my standard window, and maybe we can say f of 1 equals negative 1. And I hit draw, and there's my solution to the homogeneous differential equation. So that's about all I have to say about this particular app. If you want to learn more about linear differential equations, you can always click on the link that says information about second order differential equations, and that will send you to some information. So thank you for watching this video.